everyone. Today is August 2, or I should say September 2, 2022. It is 6 p.m. and 25 degrees Celsius. We are here today at Bloor Street and Bel Air Street in the Yorkville area of Toronto. We're starting our walk in front of the Harry Rosen store on Bloor Street. There's the new location of the Brooks Brothers store. That was located inside of Yorkville, near the Bay subway station, beside the Starbucks. They have relocated here to Bloor Street. And here's a steel brand dump there. Go over into the Manulife Center building, which is just right over here across the street. Then I'm going to get a bottle of water so I can rehydrate as I make these walking videos. There's the Italy store. I'm gonna cross over here and enter into the Manulife Center building. Here's a look west down Bloor Street. Here's a look to the east on Bloor Street. Going into the Manulife Center building. As soon as you enter, you feel the air conditioning, which is very nice and cool. And there's the Bank of Montreal. Store and they sell shoes of various kinds. There's the Pilot Coffee Roasters. And this is where I'll be going to get my water. This is called the City Market.
It will, like, give you so much attention.
It says Independent City Market. I think it's kind of like a Loblaws of some sort. But they might be owned by independent owners, as opposed to a corporate head office owning them. Natural spring water that I'm looking for. And they got music playing, so I hope that I don't get a copyright strike. Self-checkout, check myself out. Thank you. Now check out here. And let's click on pay. No Optimum card, because it always disappears when I'm ready to scan it. Yeah, I just scan my card. And says, please remove your bag, take your seat.
Thank you for using self-checkout.
And here we go.
Thank you for using.
And I'll just throw my receipt into the paper bin. Here's the Skasha, or Skasha, I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, Skasha restaurant. They serve Italian food there. Water in my backpack, and I'll be right back. And I just put my water bottle in my backpack. And I'm feeling a bit hungry. I think I'm gonna grab a sandwich from the Subway store. Street and Charles Street. We're still in the Yorkville area. I'm going to be crossing over to the west side of Bay Street. Here's the Subway sandwich store. I'm gonna go inside and grab a sandwich and I'll be right back. Man, I just had a sandwich at Subway Sandwiches. And I feel much more refreshed. And I'm now walking north on Bay Street. There's a look east on Charles Street.
There's
I mean, you have infinite amount of work once your PhD starts, yeah. But now it's kind of a weird period. Connor had the same thing, where he was basically applying for CGSM when he was in the boys.
Down quite a bit, and there's the occasional cool breeze. There's the Indigo store. I believe that this store used to be Chapters, then Indigo bought Chapters and they became Indigo Chapters. And it seems like they have now removed the chapters portion of their name, and it's now just Indigo. Here at Bloor Street and Bay Street. Here's a look east on Bloor Street. Looks like there's a lot of traffic westbound into downtown. And there's a look toward the west on Bloor Street. here's Hazukido Yorkville. And they serve all kinds of various kinds of croissants with all kinds of different flavors and toppings on them. Paramount Fine Foods restaurant.
Do you feel the rain on your head? Is there rain on you? Whoosh.
Yorkville Avenue and Bay Street. We're now turning west on Yorkville Avenue. And the sun's going down in the distance. People here at the Trattoria Nervosa restaurant. Musician playing music in the distance.
Turn on.
Looks like there's a couple there having a wedding. Or I should say taking wedding photos. There's V. Hazelton, and they got a lot of luxury brand name clothing there. There's a store called Kodali. It's on the left side of the what used to be the Heffel store. The Heffel used to have two stores. That one's still there, but this one looks like they've closed down. And beside it is the Kodali store, and that's a looks like a skincare products kind of store. Let's head down this way on Scollard Street. Here's a building that's colored all pink. It's called the Webster. Looks like a clothing store. Looks like they've got women's clothing here. Seems to be a women's clothing store. There's a development going on here. It says Cirque Developments. Together building for the future. It says Manpower Demolition Inc. So maybe they're in the process of demolishing it. Looks like this building's here for sale. This used to be the Sokolov and Associates personal injury law firm. I'm quite surprised that the building's for sale. Maybe they moved to another location. My guess would be that they were growing rapidly and so they needed maybe a bigger space. There's a collector studio. It says Fine Automotive Memorabilia. I'm gonna walk closer and see if I get a better, closer view. This is at 72 Scollard Street. There's a bit of reflection in the mirror, so it's really hard to see. But that looks like a race car helmet. And there's a model of a sports car. It looks like a Ferrari car beneath it. And over here is the plastic surgery clinic. We're now at Scollard Street and Bay Street. So they're building a building here at 50 Scollard Street. Actually, well, let's go south on Bay Street. Here's a close-up of a traffic control box that has been painted on. And this is a unique and very colorful mural. Here's a dental surgeon office, or dental surgery office, I should say. It says Dr. Afsar and Dr. Char Q. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. Here's Pusateri's. Looks like they're doing some repairs and maybe some renovations here. Pretty cool blue color for a Porsche. We're now walking west on Cumberland Street. about to reach Bel Air Street. Here's the Sassafras restaurant. It says N Heart K. I'm not sure if this has to do with the wedding photos that couple was having. Maybe they're having some sort of a party here or a celebration of some sort. That's pretty cool. Looks like there's a sign in front of the Watchfinder store. It says gone fishing. It says no access to phone or emails. Closed until September the 6th. Looks like the Dimmy restaurant and Hemingway's is pretty busy today. They usually are around this time. Three-wheeler. And I'm gonna have to end this one here. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button. For more videos like this, please hit the subscribe button and the bell notification icon. And I will see you in the next one. Take care.